guys. Shout out to Stage Guy here. Welcome back to Edith Finch. And last time we left off, it was in, I think, her room. But anyway, let's continue.
I got the sense Edie had spent a lot of time here before my mom sealed the doors.
Oh, this is Molly's room. Okay, I see. Molly Finch.
December 13th, 1947. Dear Diary, I'll be gone soon, but I wanted to tell somebody about what's gonna happen. It started when Mom sent me to bed without dinner. I woke up and I was starving, so I looked around for something to eat.
Oh, I get to play as Molly? Okay, that's cool.
The gerbil food was dry, but I didn't mind it.
Ew, she ate the gerbil food. It was a carrot anyway. I guess she must have been really hungry.
Mom, can I come out now?
Sweetheart, it's late. Go to sleep.
I kept eating and eating.
Ah, she's gonna eat toothpaste. She's gonna get sick.
I ate a lot of things that night. Then I heard chirping outside my window.
Did you know? Oh wait, let's see what happens. I thought about me.
I thought about eating Christopher, but I held back.
Okay, I see.
It was a barn swallow going back to her nest.
Okay.
I reached out for her. And suddenly...
Oh, that's cool.
I was a cat.
Okay. Okay, I'm a cat now.
I tried to be quiet, but the bird was really scared.
Come on, birdie.
Mom and Dad didn't even look at me.
Cool.
I jumped and I almost got her.
So you're getting a little mad too.
I could tell she was getting really tired.
Uh-oh, I missed. Hang on. Let's jump back on the table. Or do I?
Now I was up in the big tree. I promised Dad I wouldn't climb it anymore. All I cared about was eating that mama bird.
Is it a nightmare? I mean, a dream? Come here, birdie.
I gobbled her up. And suddenly, I was an owl. first, all I heard was the wind. Then I heard little teeth nibbling in the grass. She was almost too big to carry. I started choking, but I couldn't stop eating. And suddenly, I was a shark!
Whoa! How'd you turn into a shark?
And into the ocean. Now, I was hungrier than ever.
I swim down. Like the right bumper. You go up or down.
Grabbed on tight. so hungry, I jumped out of the water.
Yeah.
When I opened my eyes, everything had changed.
I'm an octopus.
Now I was a monster, and I smelled people everywhere. I was big, but I moved real quiet.
Okay, I do real quiet.
Also, I did it.
It's like turning to all the creatures. Seriously, how did he not hear that?
Passenger, I was still hungry. And across the water, I smelled something new. Something I had to have. So I swam towards it.
What was that?
I slithered onto the sand, and the good smell went into an old pipe.
Am I a snake now? But like I'm a snake. Am I a snake? I'm still the octopus. Oh man.
I got closer and closer.
No. No, not the little girl, no. You thought we could eat the little girl.
All of my stomach started growling. And suddenly, I was me again. I held my breath for a long time, but I couldn't hear anything. I think it's waiting for me to fall asleep. But it's not going to wait much longer. It needs to be, and we both know.
That was an interesting story, Molly.
I'm not sure if I believed all of that, but I'm sure Edie would have.
Yeah, about the cat part.
This will be obvious later, but my mom never told me any of these stories. Edie would have, but mom didn't like bringing up the past. Though, when we adopted a stray kitten, she was the one who named it Molly.
Makes sense. I guess Molly really loved cats.
I spent a lot of time in Great-Grandma Edie's room.
Alright. Seems like we're about to go into another story. Until next time. See you in the next video.